congratulations. You're through to the quarterfinals of the William Hill World Darts Championship with an emphatic 4-0 win. Was that a little bit easier than what you were expecting before a dart was thrown?
Yeah, it felt easy up there, but I was playing well. That's why I felt comfortable up there. Looked like the first set of that I even started when he went 2-0 up. It's like I just walked on and gave him two legs for nothing. But after that, I started playing darts. My grouping was good, my doubles was good. But then when I got like 2-0 up in the set, he started coming back at me. I started missing. But yeah, comfortable result at the end.
Did you switch off a little bit thinking the job was done then, because you were so far in front?
I didn't switch off, I just missing. Like, if I win 4-0, I missed a double top, and I thought it was in. All three darts, but I went wild when I walked up to it. But it didn't go, but I just regrouped and got the last leg done.
Shows you're in a good place now, because when you missed 8 darts for the set, previously, you'd have let that bother you, but today you didn't.
That's what I've worked on a lot, like, don't let anything bother me. You go 2-0 down, you can still win the set. And I can enter there, I went 2-0 down and won the set. But I also went 2-0 up and got 2-2 in the set. And then I had to pull out a good leg of my own.
Blockbuster, quarterfinal up next against Gary Anderson.
Yeah.
Last time you played him on TV, you beat him in the World Series.
Yeah.
And also last time here, you served up an absolute classic. Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Me and Gary, it can be a bad game or it can be a really good game. I don't think when the last time I beat him, it wasn't that. It was like as a first to six nervy game. It wasn't brilliant, but 2 years ago when I played him, it was one of the games of the tournament.
Is it frustrating for yourself? Because we all know how good your game is, but yet this is only your second quarterfinal appearance in 8 years. Is that frustrating for someone with your ability not to have been here more often?
Yeah, it's probably because I'm lazy at home. I don't practice enough, but. My wife was like mad at me to practice all the time, so I've actually listened to it for once and I've done it. And that's why my performances are coming out, and I'm battling hard. Even when like 2 sets down, I still battle, I don't give in. But yeah, I thank my wife a little bit for pushing me a little bit more.
Is that a case of having to? Because the standing is so good now, where if you don't practice, you're going to get left behind, where we all know you shouldn't be where you are.
Yeah, I agree. Like, practice, if you don't practice, well, I didn't do it for the first part of the year. I was very lazy, like I just said. And I was getting a bit comfortable. I was like not even in the game, most of them. And I was getting really wound up with it. And then the switch of the button practice, and it's all coming back.
Did being left out of the Premier League this year hurt you then?
No. To be fair, I always said I didn't deserve to be in the Premier League last year. This year, whatever it was, because I had a bad year. And it's all not preparing me and just going out and getting and doing silly things, which I shouldn't have done. But last 6 months, I've just started to say, if I want to be in this business, I've got to practice and I'm going to get it all. But it's all up to me then.
Dave, congratulations on a great performance and all the best in the quarterfinals tomorrow, mate. Thank you very much.
Thank you.